This is a copyrighted work. Unauthorized copying or distribution is a crime punishable by up to 5 years in prison and a fine of $250,000.
Scholastic Audio presents Dragon Masters Book 16, Call of the Sound Dragon, by Tracey West, read by Emily Ellet. Before we start, while the Dragon Masters world is not the real world, many of the characters and places in it are inspired by real-world cultures. For this reason, I'll be pronouncing the names of these characters and places the way they'd be pronounced in the real world. These pronunciations may differ from how you think a name might sound based on its spelling alone. Chapter 1, The Wizard Watch. Bright purple energy swirled around Nehru the Thunder Dragon. Echo, his dragon master, stood next to him. The green dragon stone she wore glowed. Echo reached out with both arms. Nehru's energy swirled around her, then it poured out of her hands. Drake, Rory, Bo, and Anna watched with wide eyes, excited to see Echo use her powers as a dragon mage. The energy from Echo's hands turned into a wall of purple energy. "Cool force field!" Drake exclaimed. He had once seen Echo use Nehru's energy to make a whip of purple light, but he had never seen her make a force field before.
"My connection with Nehru is so strong that I can tap into his energy and use it," Echo said. "That is what it means to be a dragon mage."
She lowered her hands, and the energy wall disappeared.
"That was awesome," Rory exclaimed.
Bo raised his hand.
"What exactly can dragon mages do with their dragon's energy?"
"They use that energy to perform some of their dragon's powers," she explained. "It takes many years to learn this. I can't create a thunder blast like Nehru does, but I can use his energy to make a regular power blast, or create a force field like I just did."
"Petra is going to be sorry she missed this," Drake said. "If I go get her, will you make another force field?"
Echo smiled.
"Of course."
It's strange seeing Echo smile, Drake thought as he ran to Griffith's wizard workshop. Echo had been Griffith's first student. She had made some bad choices in the past, but recently she had risked her life to save Drake and Rory from a dark wizard named Maldred. Maldred had trapped Echo in time with a bunch of his wizard enemies. The time dragon had freed Echo and all the wizards. Now Echo was back in the castle, helping Griffith teach the Dragon Masters. The wizards were another problem. Some of the wizards trapped in the wall were evil, and now they were on the loose.
"Petra, come see what Echo can do," Drake told the curly-haired girl, who was busy helping Griffith.
"In a minute, we're almost done with the first part of the wizard watch," Petra said. Griffith looked in Maldred's journal and found the names of the trapped wizards.
She pointed to a sheet of paper on the wall.
"I wrote their names on this chart. Now Griffith is marking the bad ones."
"If we find them, we can keep an eye on them in case they start causing trouble," Griffith said.
"That sounds like a good plan," Drake replied.
"Indeed," the wizard agreed.
He turned to Petra.
"I can finish this myself. You should go train with the others."
"Are you sure?" Petra asked. "I could..."
Boom!
A loud sound erupted from Griffith's gazing ball. Rainbow light swirled inside the ball.
"What's happening?"
Drake cried. Chapter 2, Trouble in Remus.
"I asked the gazing ball to alert me of any unusual wizard activity," Griffith explained.
He waved his hand over the glass ball.
"It must have spotted something."
Echo, Rory, Anna, and Bo raced into the workshop.
"We heard a loud boom," Bo cried.
"What's going on?" Anna asked.
Just then, the rainbow light faded, and a scene appeared inside the glass. Everyone crowded around the gazing ball. They saw a large stone arena with tall archways. It was shaped like a circle and open to the sky. The arena sat in the middle of a city.
"That's the city of Remus," Petra remarked.
A strange red and yellow mist hung over the arena.
"That mist looks magical," Drake said.
Griffith nodded.
"That mist is the sign of a wizard battle," he said. "When wizards fight each other, their magic builds up and gets out of control. That is why wizard battles are forbidden."
Petra checked the chart up on the wall.
"Griffith, a wizard named Marco came from Remus."
"Yes."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.